connect the dots. All you do is connect the dots. Now for poverty. Hi, my name is Poverty. I've been kept under wraps so no one can see. I've been on the rise without a hitch, and no one seems to care, especially the rich. If you want to know what's going on, find out who lights the plot. If you want to know who moves the car, all you do is connect the dots. All you do is connect the dots.
Now we're talking about war.
Corporate welfare. I want corporations to get their fair share. I grant them billions without inspection, because they pay the tab for my re-election. If you want to know what's going on, find out who writes the plot. If you want to know who moves the ball, all you do is connect the dots. All you do is connect the dots. We just added this because of we want more transparency in our trade agreement about the TPP. Ready? Hi, my name is TPP. I'm so surprised you haven't heard of me. If I'm approved, my secret trade deal will let corporations continue to steal. If you want to know what's going on, find out who writes the plot. All together, if you want to know who moves the pawn, all you do is connect the dots. All you do is connect the... One more time, if you want to know what's going on, find out who writes the plot. If you want to know who moves the pawn, all you do is connect the dots. All you do is connect the dots.
You hold this first. Hold everyone else. She doesn't discriminate. It doesn't matter if you look good in the picture or not. It's not.
Hey everyone, welcome to San Francisco Generation, the International March Against Corruption. How y'all doing?
abortion services. If your 13-year-old, 12-year-old daughter
sent to a Roman Catholic hospital, is she going to get a morning after pill? Or is she going to have to endure a pregnancy? Why is that? That's allowed because of loopholes. That's loopholes, and that's a failure of the separation of church and state. So after today, we have another march on the 8th, International Women's Day. We're hoping to ratify ERA and CEDAW. And on March 8th at 10 o'clock, launching from Golden Gate Bridge, there will be a march across the United States of America. Helene DeBosier will be walking from San Francisco to Washington, D.C., where she'll be joined by Code Pink, SF Now, the National Organization for Women, and many other women's organizations. All kinds of organizations are going to join us March 8, 2015 at the White House Fest, because this ERA was written by Alice Paul. And we remember that. Back in the 20s, do we remember her getting arrested at the White House trying to get this very amendment? She was force-fed. She was imprisoned. Helene's going to do that. She's going to chain herself and occupy that White House fence. She's promising to do that. So I hope we're all going to be out there to support her March 8, 2015. Connect those dots.
Woo! We don't need to. We're all over the map.
Thank you, Mona Lisa. Does millions of dollars spent by the Mormon and Roman Catholic Church sound like democracy for the people?
No!
I didn't think so. This is Farah from Code Pink. Please give her a hand. She's going to talk about war, peace, and money.
Woo!
How's everybody doing?
Good!
Can you hear me?
Yes.
My name is Farah, and I'm originally from Iraq. I came here in 2008, and I've been working with different organizations. Right now, I'm an organizer with Code Pink, and I'm also an organizer with Cars to Resist and the Private Manning Support Network. So I just feel so privileged and honored that we are gathered here at the Chelsea Manning Plaza, because it's so appropriate that we gather at this point. Chelsea Manning was one of the people who exposed war crimes and exposed corruption that was committed by the U.S. military and by even the Iraqi government against the Iraqi people. Chelsea Manning acted upon her conscience. She did not want to live with the atrocities that she saw that were committed in the name of democracy and in the name of freedom against civilians and even her fellow soldiers. Her fellow soldiers who, today, we read in the news that nearly 22 people commit suicide every day after coming back from war. Is that justice?
No.
That's corruption to me. That is absolute corruption. When Chelsea Manning came across documents about Iraqis asking for their right to know where the oil money is going, and the American military handed them over to the Iraqi government to execute them, she reported that to her superiors, but they did not listen to her. In fact, they told her to look away. She had no other choice but to expose these crimes, and she did. As she did service for the democracy of this country, as well as the democracy in anywhere in the world, especially in Iraq, where it was occupied to implement democracy, where there is no sense of democracy in that country whatsoever. My people are still suffering 11 years after the invasion, 2 years after the troop withdrawal, and Iraqis are still suffering today from atrocities committed by the Iraqi government that was, quote-unquote, democratic. And the same thing happening to the Afghani people today. I mean, Hamid Karzai, how long has he been in power? And who's responsible for that? Who's responsible for the people that are dying in Afghanistan every day? Even more so, who's responsible for the deaths in the military that are happening every day? Whether they die in Afghanistan, in Iraq, or they die even here in their homes with their families. That's corruption. And Edward Snowden is no stranger from what he saw as well behind the closed doors of the NSA, where a lot of the lies and a lot of the plots that have been made to spy and surveil innocent people inside and outside of America, he too acted on his conscience, because he did not want to live with what he saw. He exposed corruption. This is why we are here today, because we all care about democracy, and we don't just care about democracy in America. We care about democracy everywhere. I care about democracy because I'm a global citizen, and I see and I feel and I live with everybody who cares about freedom and cares about democracy and our right to demand transparency, whether transparency here or elsewhere. It is our right as human beings to know our name, in the name of freedom, in the name of democracy, in the name of transparency. This is not fair. And this is exactly why we are here. We are marching because we demand our right to know. We demand our right to see and know and listen and learn about what's happening in our name. So thank you everyone for joining us. And let's all march to demand our right to end corruption.
Thank you so much, Ralph.
Hey! for rich people.
Now.
End corruption. Now.
End corruption.
Now.
End corruption.
End that shit.
Come on.
way you want to go. What's this spot?
That was awesome, guys. Everyone having a good time? Woo! We're here to protest big money in politics. What do you think about that? Woo! So we've got Captain J stretching up. Looks like a rally. Rapid time in about talking money and politics. So here he is. Give him a hand. Yo, yo, how you guys doing today?
How you guys?
Political system with race you do. We give the people economic disintegration, international isolation. Plus the price that we're paying for gas is ragging. So I'm up for speculation, and I guess I'm patient, but they're kicking the corporate welfare. Oil subsidies taking bucks from me. Golden parachutes holding autocrats. Enough war going on here before I rest. Loopholes and tax and tax shelters too. So now corporations are essentially taxing you. Partisan policies and power grabs. Got most of America watching the hourglass until it's time to march.
Sleeping in the park. It's now a misdemeanor. People end up going to jail.
may not least, we've got Ty Kirk from 99 Rides. He's going to talk to you about the growing movement to reclaim democracy from the 1% back to the 99% to have a democracy, not a plutocracy. Give it up for Ty Kirk. Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, Michael Sullivan coming up. Oh!